Hey everyone, I'm Nog and welcome back to Satisfactory. In between episodes, I have been doing quite a bit of work. As you can see over here, before we had 12 coal generators, 6 here and 6 here, now we have 8 on each side. So yeah, and that was basically because, well, we short-circuited. So we were spending more power than we were generating, and we need to go bigger with the power very soon because we're not generating enough. Okay, over here on the building that I'm standing, I have put in the second floor of our factory, and that took quite a while, I would say, because if we just go down a little bit. Well, let's just let's jump down here. As you can see, I have put up walls everywhere, and I've done it all the way around. So that is nice. Also, I'm not gonna be pointing fingers or anything like that, because pointing fingers is no help, and it's not very nice either. But some dummy forgot to configure 6 of these foundries, so they were basically there, and they had the resources that they needed, but they hadn't been told what to do. So, so yeah, that is one of the reasons that we were not producing very much or very many iron ingots. So I fixed that up, so now we are producing a ton, and we are actually producing more than we are using. As you can see, we are fully backed up on steel ingots. So that's great. I can't believe I forgot to do that, and I was like, I was running around, it took me forever to figure out why the hell I didn't have more steel ingots coming out. I was doing all kinds of stuff, but I figured it out. It was because I didn't configure 6 of the 8 forges. Also, for some reason, in one of these splitters, there was a Mark II belt inside the splitter. So when I tore that out, I could see that because everything was getting backed up here, and then along this line here, the main line, the coal wasn't really flowing, or it was getting backed up right here, I think, and then it went fast again, so I wasn't getting the throughput that I needed. I have also upgraded all of the Mark II belts to Mark III belts. I'm not sure if I had already done that, but it's done anyway. So yeah, there's that. Also, what else did we do? What else did we do? Oh yeah, if we go over here. Oh, there's a sewer sloop up there. I need to go get that at some point. I have fixed up the coal delivery area a little bit, so it looks a little bit nicer, and I have also put in a second tractor, because one tractor simply wasn't enough to feed this belt, so I put in a second one, and I have also upgraded the coal miners to Mark II and installed Mark III belts there. I have also built a bit of a road most of the way, I think, over to the coal. Not all the way, but at least on this side of the river that we were crossing to get there, I have installed road all the way and over to the bridge and integrated the bridge in the road. So there's that. Then if we run in here, I have also, as you see, I built the walls all the way around, and I have installed this sky bridge, which goes all the way around and over to some small balconies on each side, as well as this central hub area thingy where I've installed a equipment workbench and a crafting bench and some personal storage chests, just so we have them and we can go here and craft and stuff if we want. But I think this turned out quite well. If we run over here to the side, I mean, the view is quite nice here, but I think it's even better if we go over here like this. I think this looks pretty great, and I like the factory feel of the of this whole whole building. I think it's very cool. We do need to get, I think, at least our steel and our copper, and I think the top line of iron as well. We need to get those up to the second floor, so I'm thinking of bringing them over here in the corner and building a conveyor escalator thingy here going up through the floor. I think we'll do that because we're using nowhere near the steel, at least, that we need. And I'm pretty sure we're not using all the copper that we're producing, and also not the entire top line. We're using the entire bottom line of iron, but not the top one. So yeah, there's that. If we run over here, I don't remember, did I do something over on this side? I'm not sure. I don't think so. Let's just check. Other than build the balcony here, I don't think I did anything. No, not really. So yeah, but what we can do is, I wonder, let's just jump down here. I do want to get, I think I want a ramp going down here so we can get down here and not having to go all the way over there all the time. If we look at our storage, quickly, our steel beams is completely full, our steel pipes are completely full, our stators are not, they're getting there, almost halfway full, our iron plates are certainly full, pipes, or rods, sorry, screws, pretty much everything down here is full, except for the rotors, I think. And the frames, but the frames are getting there as well, and the rotors are getting there too. So yeah, we have quite a few items stored up. Let's just run over here so we don't have to jump all over all of those belts. All right, and if we go upstairs where we only have one item, which is motors, that is sort of getting there as well. So yeah, there, it's halfway full, pretty much. So yeah, that is what has happened in between episodes. I also did some exploring in between episodes, mainly because I really wanted to find Caterium. And it took forever. I have explored quite a lot trying to find Caterium, and I finally succeeded. So if we look in here, I think we have 168 Caterium ore, which is great. We also have found 4 hard drives, 7 green slugs, a yellow slug, and a purple slug. So yeah, that is pretty cool. Let's grab one of the hard drives now. And, oops. Stick that in the MAM so we can research that. Oh, and the MAM is done with mycelia, which is great. So, that's good. Actually, maybe we should do the criteria more before.
This mycelia can be used to create fabrics. The derived blueprint is now accessible in Hub Tier 1. Additionally, R&D has requested extra samples to determine the cause of an anomaly.
15 minutes for Caterium ore. I think we're going to do Caterium ore first. So that we... I think if we research the Caterium ore, then I think we can scan for it. Which would be nice, because I didn't find any mineable node. I just found some the hand mining rocks. So we learned about fabric, or we need to research fabric as well, and I guess we can research mycelia again for something. I have no idea what, but the Caterium ore is what I want right now, so let's do that. I have also gone ahead and gotten ready to launch the space elevator. So we have 500 frames and 150 motors here. So let's go do that. A little bit dangerous running down here, but it's fine. Because the tractors, they do actually run you over. So, but I actually have three tractors going over to the coal area over here now. But they seem to be running fine and not getting in trouble running into each other and stuff like that. So that's good. So let's run over here and configure this. Need 500. What the hell? Come on. Okay. 500 frames done and 150 motors, and let's launch the space elevator and get tiers 5 and 6 unlocked finally. That is going to be very nice. Let's send it. There we go. And let's watch it go. Pow. Off it goes. Fantastic. All right. So let's get back over here. Man, it feels like I run slow. Really, really slow. Okay, let's go see what we unlocked in tiers 5 and 6. That's gonna be interesting. So, let's see, what do we have left in tier 2 and 3? We have jump pads and the color gun, which I do want to get unlocked as well. And the rebar gun. I have heard that the rebar gun absolutely sucks, so that's why I haven't hurried to get it. Tier 5, oil processing. Oil pump, oil refinery, plastic, fuel, rubber, circuit board, and scanner update for crude oil. So this is definitely something that we want, I think. Industrial manufacturing, manufacturer and the truck and the computer. Definitely something we want too. Expanded power infrastructure, fuel generator and conveyor belt Mark IV. Now that fuel generator is something I really want. Jetpack, I really, really want, and it also gives 5 in more inventory slots, which will be very nice. And the gas mask and filter. Okay. Some of these look really expensive to make. But we're gonna have to do it. We are going to have to do it. This one isn't too bad. We could unlock that right now, actually. Just by picking up the materials. So, and the same with this one. You know what, let's unlock oil processing so that we can start scanning for crude oil and stuff. So let's select the milestone. We need 50 and 50. It's really not too bad. Let's go get the motors first. And then we can get the rest downstairs. Motors. There we go. Then we need cable, frames, and upper wire. Or just wire. It's called, I guess. Let's go have a look. Where do we have the stuff that we need? There. Whoops. Come on. This is, wire we have over here. So let's grab some of that. We need 2,500. Let's grab 3,000 so we have some on us. And then we need frames and cable. Cable is right here. We need 300, so let's grab. We have 100 on us. And then frames, not there, there. We have 50 of those. We don't really need to have any of those on us, I think. Let's just get 50. We'll have them. All right. So that means that we can unlock oil processing. Maybe we should get jump pads unlocked as well so that we can get up and down a little bit easier. I think that might be a good idea. So let's see. Motors. Wire and cable. There we go. Let's do it. Oil processing unlocked. And it's been a while since we've seen this guy go.
Oil based products can now be made. Caution, this is a reminder to minimize the chance of expiration during out of base activities.
Off you go. We're good. So that's done, and the MAM is certainly not done with the caterium yet, I'm pretty sure. So I have also speeded the overclock this one by up to 250%, and I've installed a Mach 2 miner over here because we were not producing enough concrete when I was building all of this. But this seems pretty good. But I do want to get it moved in here, which is why I put in a window up here. And I think I want to put in... I want to install another Mach 2 miner on another limestone and have a lot of concrete production, because we use so much of it when we're building like this. So I want a lot of concrete production so we don't have to wait for it, which I actually did sometimes in this build. I had to wait for concrete to be made. So that wasn't any fun. So let's see, how much can we fit in here? It's just constructors. Oh, I want them to come out this way. Well, I guess we can fit maybe 4 constructors. Making this stuff, we could build them this way. think that's what we'll do. I think we can get four constructors in here. Maybe not, we maybe don't have enough room to also get biofuel down here, but then we can just move it upstairs. That's fine. So I think we'll want four constructors set up here. Let's try it. One, two, three, four. Can I get? I don't think I can get. We need a splitter. Actually, we need a few splitters. There. I want to do something different with this anyway. Let's see. Three splitters. Let's just tear this down. You can always just put it all the way over on the side, which we might do. Or do something completely different. I don't know yet. But what we can do is get conveyor belt Mark 3 in here. And get it here, I think. Yeah. And what's it encroaching? Dang it. Okay. We'll figure something out for getting up there. Let's not worry about that right now. So splitters. Let's just. Why is it not lining up? There it is. One. Two. Three. That seems right. And this machine is not lined up at all. Let's just get that done, or it'll drive me crazy. There. And then we can do like that. Like that. And I think we only need not one belt going in here. Yeah. Let's just configure them so that's done. And we don't forget, like I did with the. What's it called? Steel ingots. And here. Oh, I need to get some more steel beams. Luckily, we have a few ready to grab over here. Just like that. And go get this built. There. And no, I don't want that. I just want one belts in here. This is a bit anticlimactic, actually. We just unlocked oil processing and we haven't even scanned for oil yet. I think we should do that once we've hooked this in. like that. Let's see, we need some power. Let's get some power in here. One, two. Let's just get them running, then at least that's done. Can we grab some power from over here somewhere? Yes, we can. There. That's hooked up. And then we just need an output as well, which we'll need mergers for. One, two, three. And we certainly just need Mach 1 belts for that to come in there. This will mean that we're done with the ground floor, which will be very nice. We can start building upstairs. And like that. And then I guess we'll get you going up here. I can't actually get up there right now. Let's try and see if we can get up there somehow. Walkway ramp. There. There. And a turn. That. Like that. And another turn. Or another ramp. Sorry. Like that. This isn't the prettiest, but we can get up. This looks a bit weird. Okay, no one. There's the tractor bringing us some coal. So get you stuck in there and stuck in there. And there. So we have input, we have output. All we need to do now is we can tear this down, move that, and we can get this going in. Here, there. So that should mean that we start getting some what's it called, concrete made. Let's see, this we are, and it's going up into storage. Very nice. Very nice. Looks like all the belts are hooked up correctly. Good, good, good. So that's done. Let's, you know what? Let's leave it here for today. And next time we will find out what the Caterium research does for us, as well as we will go find some oil, which we can now scan for. So we can see that there. So very, very cool. So thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, why not leave a like and maybe subscribe so you don't miss out on future episodes. And I'll see you next time.